بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, I have a great news for you today. There is a beautiful hadith, subhanAllah, from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Of course, this gift Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only has given to the worshippers, to those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the day and during the night. If you want to have a protector, bodyguard through all your day and all your night, and that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To all, one of the gifts, what I'm going to mention this hadith is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to you angels to protect you in that day. All what you need to do, my dear brother and sister, listen to this hadith. It's a beautiful dhikr, and that dhikr, you can say it after Salatul Fajr or after Salatul Maghrib. In Salatul Fajr and in Salatul Maghrib. The hadith which is collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi fi sunanihi bi sanadin hasan, hadith came from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man qala la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lah lahul mulku وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير 10 times. Subhanallah. One more time. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير 10 times إثر المغرب. Whoever says this dua 10 times after the Salatul Maghrib, what is the reward? كَتَبْ بَعَثَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مَسْلَحَةً يعني حَرَسًا. Allah sent it to him protectors, the angels who come down to protect you. Protect you from who? حَرَسًا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ حَتَّى يُصْبِهِ till morning. Subhanallah. You have a protector till morning. It's not just there. The hadith doesn't stop here, the dua. The reward of this dua, the Prophet says, وَكَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَهُ 10 good deeds. And it's written for him 10 good deeds, mandatory good deeds for him. وَمَحَى عَنْهُ 10 مُبِقَاتٍ. Subhanallah. He give you these 10 good, huge good deeds, is written for you. And Allah wipes away 10 bad deeds, mubiqat, from the big ones, from the major ones, subhanallah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes on and he mentions in the hadith, and he says, وَكُتِبَ لَهُ 10 رَقَبَاتٍ مُؤْمِنَاتٍ. Subhanallah. And it's written for him like he has free 10 slaves from among the believers. All this huge reward, my brothers and sisters, by saying 10 times after the Maghrib. The second hadith, what has some explanation and some extra reward, extra bonus from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is Kareem. He, you do little, He gives you a lot. Hadith Abu Dharr al-Ghafari radiallahu anhum, and this hadith is also in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "من قال في دبر صلاة الفجر ثاني رجليه قبل أن يتكلم." يعني whoever says this dua after the Salat al-Fajr, he's still in a position of the prayer before he starts talking. I mean, he finishes the salah and he still is in a sitting position before he starts talking. What does he say? لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير 10 times. The same dua you say after the Salatul Fajr 10 times. What is the reward, my dear brother and sister? كتبت له 10 حسنات ومحى عنه 10 سيئات. Up to here, the same dua. Up to here, Allah writes for him 10 حسنات and wipe for him 10 سيئات. Then hadith goes, وَرُفِعَ لَهُ 10 درجات. In the Jannah, Allah gave him 10 levels in Jannah, higher. And hadith in Bukhari, between each darajah is almost 100 ni'atu'am, the distance of 100 years. You get it? Just by saying this dua. The hadith doesn't stop right here. The Prophet ﷺ says, وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ الْيُومْ حِرْزٌ مِنْ كُلِّ مَكْرُوهٍ. And in that day, Allah just protect him, that they become protected from any evil act, any calamity, كُلِّ مَكْرُوهٍ. وَحُرِسَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. Subhanallah. And is protected from the shaitan, from the obstacles of the shaitan, from the whispers of the shaitan. This is if you do it after Salat al-Fajr. The Prophet ﷺ says, then he goes, the hadith goes on, وَلَمْ يَنْبَغِي لِذَنْبٍ أَنْ يُدْرِكَهُ فِي ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ إِلَّا شِرْكٌ بِاللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. The Prophet says, it's not befitting any sin. There is no sin in that day which can destroy this hasanat, these good deeds which Allah has given it to you, except if you do shirk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look the reward, my dear brothers and sisters, in Salatul Maghrib and Salatul Fajr. You say this dua, this dhikr, which is beautiful dhikr. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulku, wa lahul hamdu, yuhyi wa yumeet. وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Except you have all this reward. The angels coming to protect you all day. There is no evil will touch you. Your level in Jannah is so high. Allah wipes away the bad deeds, even if they are major. And Allah just writes for you good deeds, huge good deeds. Subhanallah. Can anybody after this tell us, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not Kareem, it's not generous. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, do not forget this dhikr after the prayer of Fajr and Maghrib. So make sure you pray Fajr. Make sure you pray Maghrib. Make sure you pray all salawat, because the reward is huge. Every prayer has a huge reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salatul Fajr, you cannot even imagine the reward. Salatul Isha, you cannot even imagine the reward. Salatul Asr, you cannot even imagine a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to open our heart, to open my heart and your heart, and keep this adhkar. Teach your family, teach your kids, teach your brother. You meet him in the street, you say, let me tell you hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, and I hope you apply this in your life. Look the reward, you get it. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.